I'm going to try and connect the dots from a supply chain and operations perspective, right? I mean, we talk about digital transformation. Here at Vistaprint, we've got 7 global manufacturing plants. So think about the scope. It's all over the world. It's 24/7, 2 very large plants, others smaller than the larger plants. So coming into the pandemic and just post the conversion, one of the biggest challenges was a redirection in terms of how we were thinking about manufacturing itself, right? So we were transitioning truly in earnest for the last year or so from purely a manufacturing operation to a fulfillment center concept, right? So you think about the different touch points, and Parthiv, you talked about touch points and minimizing the touch points or making these touch points transparent, right? Getting more inventory into these manufacturing locations, and now you're starting to see third-party fulfillers. You're starting to see sub-suppliers. Now, how do you expand your network, and how do you make this all-encompassing? And when the pandemic hit, we needed to quickly pivot, and which we successfully did, into the mask and the shields, which required additional collaboration with the supply base, with additional space requirements, additional agility. And all of that was possible based on a platform that was much more reliable, much steadier, and much faster to process all of this information, right? So one of the plants comes up in the morning and they're on their MRP. And how long does it take to run the MRP, and how accurate is the data? So I think those were some of the considerations that the manufacturing plants were already talking to us about. And they wanted to be able to become a more efficient fulfillment center, to extend their internal supply chain, to have better collaboration with the supply base. And all of this under the context of, do not take the system away from me. So it was even difficult to get a 2-hour downtime, and we heard a lot from Arnie and yourself also and other folks in terms of what the downtime requirements are. The requirements were very, very stringent. So if we picked a Saturday night, and think about it from the context of global operations, you pick a Saturday night and you say, I'm going to take a 2-hour downtime. Somebody is going to tell you that, no, this is not possible. You're going to impact my production schedule. You're going to impact my customer deliveries. And therefore, to be able to build functionality wherein, even if the system is down for 2 hours, can I still let the plants operate? Can I still give them a view of the data? Now, some of these things were absolutely not possible with ECC, which have now become possible with the transformation that we went through.